Good morning, Tillers.
It's Wednesday, October 4th,
and it's time for
Tiller News Today. Okay, Layla, so what does the T in E in team stand for?
Okay, so the T is think critically and the E is effectively communicate.
And the A in team stands for advanced literacy.
Got it. Okay, so think critically and advanced literacy.
Effectively communicate and advanced
literacy. Okay. I wonder if anyone else knows what team stands for.
We should check.
What's up, Tillers? My name's Kaylee, and today we're going to be seeing if the Tillers know what team stands for. Do you know what the T in team stands for?
Nah.
Do you know what the T in team stands for?
Think critically. Think critically.
Yes, yes. All right, and then what about the E?
For, I just said it this morning. Effectively communicate.
Good job, Sullivan. All right, what about the A?
Always matriculate.
Not quite. It is advanced literacy.
Advanced literacy. And then M is move swiftly to your class.
Sure, Sullivan. Whatever you want. All right, thanks. Do you know what the T in team stands for?
Think critically.
Yeah, you're right. Thank you.
Tustin.
No. Alrighty, do you know what the E in team stands for?
Effectively communicate.
Yeah, you got it right. Congratulations. What the A in team stands for?
Yes, advanced literacy.
Yeah, you got it. Congratulations. Thank you.
Do I get anything?
No, unfortunately. All right.
Can't believe it's already October 4th.
No, where has the time gone?
You can say that again.
Where has the time gone?
Okay, so how are you doing in your classes?
Dude, I'm so stressed.
Really? Can I help you?
Probably not.
Come out and join us next Wednesday, October 11th, for our mental health resource fair at lunch in the plaza.
There will be therapy dogs and agencies from the community offering resources, free items, and summer job opportunities for anyone who's interested.
You won't want to miss it, guys.
Are you interested in the military?
The Army will present in room 806 on Thursday, October 5th during lunch.
You look like you'd be in the military right now.
Oh, do I?
You do. Drop down, give me 20.
Absolutely not, sir.
AP students, you have 1 month left to register for your AP exams.
The cost is $110 per exam.
Please be sure to register and pay for the exams and total registration.
That is so expensive, Leah. You think $110 is bad? Students, if you don't register by November 3rd, you're going to pay $45 extra dollars in late fees.
Please see Ms. Hagstrom if you need help registering or have questions.
Get on that!
So Boomers was fun last week.
Yeah, I actually had a great time.
If you didn't go, you missed out, right?
Exactly.
Let's show them what they missed.
Hey, Tillers.
It's Jaden.
And Paulina Ponders.
And we're going to Boomers.
We're
and Carson.
One of the buses went missing.
Yeah.
So
Carson's comfy. A little nonsense is what I need. Now if you wanna get the best of me, I'm smiling, that's for sure. What? Wait, yeah, Boomers!
We're about to go karting!
I really think I passed.
Hello, Jaden. How are you doing today?
Oh my god, I'm so excited.
And I am currently with our anchor,
Lay. What's up, guys?
Red team will be going down. Jaden, watch out.
Let's go.
We're gonna join our friends up there.
Hey, we're gonna go.
Good times.
Right?
We're only going to be seniors in high school once.
Yeah, I'm going to make sure I go to everything.
Me too.
Speaking of things, let's check in with Paulina and Leah to find out what ASB has planned for us.
Leah, ASB has a lot planned for us at the end of this week.
I know, Paulina. Did you hear about So Good Teacher?
Today, at lunch for $5, you can dump a bucket of water on the head of your favorite teacher.
Or your least favorite, you never know. Please come out to the plaza today at lunch to participate.
Or just watch.
You won't want to miss this.
Tomorrow and Friday, we'll be decorating pumpkins and fall cookies.
So please come out and join us on the plaza stage for all of that fall fun.
Cannot wait to soak a teacher today.
Me too.
And how about pumpkin decorating?
And did you hear that drama's putting on a play?
No, which one?
It's called The Tree.
The Tree? What's it about?
Let's send it over to Jade and she can tell us all about it.
Tustin High School's theater department is proud to announce its fall play.
October 11th through the 13th, theater will present The Tree.
The Tree is a short story about five teenagers getting lost in the woods and being followed by something really, really spooky.
And what role do you play?
I play Ashley. She gets scared really easily.
Can you give us a line? Like a short little line?
It's not the same tree! Okay. Come watch our show.
And if you don't like it, we'll give you your money back.
Whoa. Whoa.
So basically, on Tuesday, October 10th, the OC LGBT Center will be visiting the GSA Club, meeting during lunch in room 5204.
Stop by to get information about events and resources provided by the center.
What's the question? Chicken or the egg? That's the question.
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Definitely the egg.
Definitely the egg? All right, thank you.
The egg, bro, because like evolution, so eventually like the species before it evolved into the
chicken. God, bro. Oh, no. Oh, God.
Egg. How is that? How is the egg there?
But like, how is the woman? How...
What came first, the chicken or the egg?
Shoot. The chicken. You game and lock in.
I'm locking in.
The chicken. No, the egg comes out the chicken, right?
Uh-huh.
So the chicken came first.
It's me. Excuse me.
The chicken.
Chicken?
God put.
That's a very popular answer.
God put the chicken here first.
On God.
Created the whole world.
On God.
For real.
The egg.
The egg.
Chicken.
Chicken because of God.
Because of God. Chicken because of God.
Because of God.
Thank you.
The egg. Nah. The egg. Yeah.
Yeah.
The chicken.
The egg.
I'ma say the egg came first.
You're a Catholic man. You know how to answer
this. Wait. What does that have to do anything? I think it's a chicken, right? Because like,
yeah. What came first, the chicken or the egg?
The chicken.
Chicken?
Yes, because God said, "Let there be chicken," and then the chickens had to lay the eggs after.
I think he said, "Let there be life." This is the end of the segment. Chicken or the egg thing.
Layla, what do you think?
The egg, for sure. How about you?
I think also the egg.
Agreed.
Yeah. Bubba, what do you think?
Definitely chicken.
What? Okay, let's send it over to Carson and Marcus for Tiller Sports.
Right behind the camera.
You don't really look like Marcus.
Well, it's not like you're exactly Carson's twin either.
Well, we thought it was about time to have some female sport anchors.
Wait. Hold a second. Hold on.
Out of our seats, imposters.
We're the new sports anchors.
Is that a challenge?
Well, how about this? You try and do a back handspring, and maybe we'll consider giving your seat back.
Light work, cheerleader.
You got it. Full. Yay!
Hi, I'm Leah.
And I'm Sienna.
And today, we're going to be miking up our sports anchors and teaching them back handsprings.
Let's go.
Do you guys have any prior experience with tumbling or cheerleading?
I have absolutely no experience.
I feel great, you know. I'm an athlete, so this is going to be easy.
Light work. Let's see how they do. Are you guys ready now?
Yeah.
You guys. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3.
Light work, huh? Say the middle's better. You said this is light work. We're ready to go.
He said it was light work.
He said it was light work.
Let's start with the handstand.
Oh.
We've got a lot of work to do, Tillers. Ready? Get your feet together. Okay. Oh gosh.
Can we go in the shade, maybe?
Who wants to go first?
Okay. You know what? Let me. This feels weird.
Ben. Push your hips forward, leaning all the way back into it. Almost there.
Push, push, push.
Thing right here keeps cramping up.
One, two, three. Push, push, push.
Did I just kick
you? Yes. He's just gotta lock in, you know? This is light work for him. Want? Okay, okay.
Okay. All right.
He's feeling good. He's ready. He's ready. All right.
Oh.
How are we feeling post-practice?
I feel great. 10 out of 10.
How about you, Carson?
I'm not really happy with my performance.
Marcus, I heard you had a crazy game last week.
Man, you know I do this, man. Felt great to be out there again.
Hey, do you think we could go all the way this year?
Is that a question? I know we can go all the way this year.
You don't want to jinx us, bro.
I'm not going to jinx us.
Anything could happen.
Hey, as long as we stay healthy, I think we can go 14-0. Hey, man, big shout out to the tennis team.
Not only is everyone on the honor roll,
they notched their first Empire League win since 2018 with a 14-4 victory over Kennedy.
It was also their 7th win of the season so far, compared to 4 total wins last year.
Harshini extended her unbeaten streak to 137 wins and
0 losses. She's the Michael Jordan of high school tennis, dude.
She's like Steph Curry.
The girls' tennis next home match is this Thursday at 3:15.
Don't forget, the detention game of the week is the varsity football game on Friday. It's going to be a blowout.
Come out to the game and clear some detention hours.
Let's see what's going on in Tiller Sports this week.
There is a woman in Somalia scraping for pearls on the roadside. There's a force stronger than nature keeps her will alive. This is how she's dying. She's dying to survive. I don't know what she's made of. I would like to be that brave. She cries to the head.
That's all for today, Tillers.
Be respectful,
be engaged,
and be determined.
Go Big Red and advance literacy.